Good morning guys, welcome back to my channel, to SiteEng. I'm already after a very strong coffee and I'm ready to go to my work. And in today's video guys, I'm going to show you the day of the life of a civil engineer on my last job, doing different kinds of works. I believe today we got a few things to do, so that should be very interesting. And guys, before we start today, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, leave the thumbs up, leave the comments if you got any questions, as this helps to grow this channel. And don't forget to follow my page on LinkedIn as well. So let's go. Guys, that's the morning, another day in paradise, as I say. That's the finger here. We're gonna go through the turnstiles. Happy days. Come in here. Look at that nice job. The guys already working here. And that's my office here. That's how my office is looking now here. There's a desk, PM is sitting there usually, and my desk is here. You see, got some drawings here already. My robotic here, we got manhole here to install the little bit of land drain, and I'm going to show you that in a minute. That's going to be my first job today, just to have a look. And once they find the pipe, I'm going to do the reading and just make sure everything is correct. So yeah guys, let's go have a look what's happening on site. So guys, my first job today is land drainage here. It's going along this wall. I'm going to show you. We start digging there. We're going to find the pipe as we run that drainage up to somewhere where that digger is actually now. I mark where the manhole is, and I'm going to show you the line of the drainage. We're going to be looking in there first. I don't know if you see this, the red mark. And after we find it, I'm going to show you. I'm going to need to take a reading just to make sure the level is okay. I'm going to show you, obviously, this man is happy. So I got few targets here. Actually, sorry, because this time I didn't use the retro. I got few retros there, one on top of that building and one behind me. But I show you what you can do also, as I put something like this, just with a pencil really, and you can use it as a station as well. Obviously it's not a retro target, but that's the point in the space, so you need the position and the level, and that's how you can base your EDM, obviously. So I got another one there, so that's another way of doing it if you don't have any retros, or you just do quickly some temporary stations just to make a quick setup later. So yeah guys, after we dig it, I'm going to show you and that will be the first job. But while I'm here guys, I want to also have a look how guys is doing here in front of block B. That's the block B, and we're doing the marketing suite here. This MSU going to be now in the building, and we're laying some paving here, and oh, you can see, so the guys doing the job there. We got this is already late here around the substation. Not much to be done by me, just to have a look and ask guys if they need anything, and to have a look if everything goes all right. So that's how it looks. We're connecting here with the existing footpath, so that's what we're using here. You can see the guys using the string lines. They set the level like that, so there's no really engineer needed for it. Once I set the first levels for this, there was actually my friend before setting all this planter here, and then once that planter is set and it's correct, I checked it, then the guys running the paving to it to the correct levels. So that's it, just a quick check, everything is all right, everyone is happy, and I'm gonna go for next job. So guys, one of my jobs here in this position I got here now is also like taking the quants and checking what we need. So I'll do some markups as well. As you can see here, I just put approximate tarmac area. In that area, I show you when we're going to doing the drainage. I do some markups for the drainage, for the services we need to install there as well. And I got, yeah, there's a bit of wall there to be rebuilt. So I do a few markups, I send it to my PM, and he's going to know what we need to order and all the stuff. I got the details here. it's upside down actually, but that's here. So I'm gonna know how we're gonna be looking, the length of the pipes we need. I'm gonna find out after we find where we finish, as I couldn't find the as-built for it. But we actually had to stop, unfortunately, because there's a cable pulling for that block now. So that's probably gonna carry on Monday, but there's always something to do. So my another quick job is, guys, this is already finished. We did externals here as well, all this paving, permeable paving, and obviously all the services below ground here. We done all the stuff, and just a little bit here, I'm just checking on, guys, the installing two benches. This is the long lead item, so just you need to make sure they're gonna come in time. And they actually came today, and that's the benches here. The guy's installing there. We already poured the foundation before we laid the paving. So you can see he's getting to the concrete now. He's gonna install them, I'll double check. He got the marks there, and I gave him dimensions as well. They got the line there. So it's simple stuff, but anyway, it's good to keep an eye on everything, really. So I'm gonna probably go now to double check that manhole there, if they found a pipe, and I'm going to show you everything anyway.
Oh, guys, we got a little bit of sunshine. I'm lucky now. I'm probably going to change in a minute anyway. So I'm going to set my EDM now, and I'm going to show you what I'm going to do, guys. I'm going to set some new targets to do the survey later after the power on. Going to go and check and connect all that cables around the substation, and I'm going to show you all of that, obviously. But I'm going to set my EDM, and I'm going to show you how I set the targets and what I'm going to do and how I'm doing it. So guys, I'm gonna be doing the resection as typical. Oh, there is a lorry coming. I hope I'm not on the way. We'll see now. Yeah, he stopped there. I hope he's not gonna be reversed anymore. I got a target there, so I hope I'm gonna hit that target. I got another one here. I don't know if you can see, and I got one. Actually, there are three, but I'm gonna use one on the substation there. I'm gonna put one on this leg here. The reason for it, obviously, guys, I want to set up my EDM later behind this hoarding here, the new hoarding. So I'm going to set one target on the hoarding, one on this leg, so I'm going to have three targets later, just to be able here to set up my EDM on this side and be comfortable, you know, wherever I need to do the resection and do the surveys and mark up wherever I need. So yeah, guys, let's go do resection, and then I'm going to set the targets. So guys, I finished my resection. 1 second, 0.02 millimeters on height, not the best. On height, I typically got zero, and I got some small error on easting northing, but I'm happy with it anyway, for this works. And what I'm gonna do, guys, now, I'm gonna show you this. I'm gonna set one retro target, and also I'm gonna do, I just do with a pencil, just across for this. And but guys, that's a good practice now. What I'm gonna show you, what I do, I just mark on the target before I fix it. This is block GNF, so I actually called it GF. That's gonna be GF1, and I'm gonna put GF2 later on the hoarding. And the reason for it, guys, once you're doing your resection and you're aiming at the targets, you know what you're aiming for. And I will show you in a minute, just on that substation, there are three targets with nothing on them, so you actually don't know if you... If you're working, obviously, you're gonna remember this, but once you come in or some new engineer comes, it's good to have it. That's a good practice, really, so keep it like that, please. So I got my GF1, I'm gonna stick it just here. I typically just try to wipe the surface a little bit so it's gonna stick properly, but on this surface it's gonna stick well, I believe. So I got my target here. Happy days. And what I'm gonna do now is obviously turn my EDM, and I'm gonna shoot it. The angle is maybe not the best, but once I'm gonna do another resection here, I'm gonna shoot it again, and then I take the average, and then I'm gonna move behind the hoarding and survey new ones. So let's go. So guys, I moved my EDM here closer to that station, so I got targets here. I know if you can, it's two targets, no names on them, nothing there, so I'm actually put something on them. That's the cables here, the power on coming to do some connections here as well. And after this, I want to do a proper survey of every single one of them with the photos. So whoever gonna dig here again by any chance, you're gonna get the proper information, unlike us here before we started here. So my one target there, and I just quickly show you here my another one. I didn't have a retro actually to use. I found only one, but I put here GF2, or maybe do like that also, so I'm gonna see it from further distance. And that's the same story, I just do the resection, do the survey. And guys, at the end of this video, I'm gonna take all these points maybe on the one drawing, and I show you how I keep all the stations, all the targets on one drawing. So whoever gonna start a job after me, or whatever engineer gonna come, or whoever gonna ask for targets, I can actually provide this information with a very useful format or DXF. You can copy this back into your EDM to make life of our engineers easy. We are guys like one big engineers family, and of course in each family you're gonna find some, but I think we should help each other, guys, and keeping the information in the good way, giving the others opportunity to just come on site and do their job properly, instead of struggling to get the base information and looking like they don't know what they're doing really, compared to the engineer living or stuff like that. And I had a few times, guys, many people are reluctant to give you the information, and they reluctant really to help you, but we're not gonna be like that, and we're gonna bring a proper practice to help each other, guys. So guys, as we say, job done. I got the new coordinates here, new stations, so I'm gonna be able to set EDM wherever I like here. You can see here, I hope, on that map, it's better now. You see, I got the survey point GF1, GF3, GF2 and GF4. So that's my new station on this side. Just on the way back, guys, I'm gonna show you how my friends from Reddington doing here. They actually fly in like always, guys. Look at the groundworks here, block C, and then block A, it's already in the air. One core here, they struck two others, and look at the high legs there. It's around 5 meters nearly. I'll double check on the drawing later. So it's really interesting project here as well. You see the concrete flying. Four cranes is not enough for these guys. Look, they got a mobile one as well. Few diggers, temporary works, a big part of works as well. I'm gonna cover here on my channel too. And yeah, guys, I'm gonna go to my task just to show you here. Look at the other blocks. Jesus, this brick is eating this. They're gonna eat that building very quickly. So you're stopped by the guys, but I see the cables are pulled already. You see the cable here. To repeat, so they were pulling these cables through the ducts, and they asked us actually to dig another little bit hole for the earthing. I see they got the earthing cable here ready, so they're gonna connect it there, and that's it. And that's good news, we can probably come back to our job with the land drainage. So we found a pipe down there, as you can see here, and I decided I'm gonna bring my EDM here. I'm gonna set it in the minute, and I'm gonna shoot that, and that'll be actually last job for today, and the weekend starts. But obviously, once I do the survey, I'm gonna plot it on the CAD drawing, and we're gonna have a look where we are, and then later I'm gonna just double check how many pipes we need to finish this job. So guys, the EDM is here set and leveled now. I got one retro target there on the back. I'm not sure if you can see it. Yeah, it's not that visible, but I got one retro there, and these targets I showed you at the beginning of the video, I'm gonna set up, and I'm gonna do survey on the pipe, and as I said, I'm gonna plot it later on the cut, and that'll be finished for today. So resection is done here. Look at this, guys. Easting 0, northing 0, height 1 millimeter. That's what we love, that's the error we are looking for. And then I'm gonna just turn the instrument now, and I don't know if you're gonna see this on the pipe. You see the laser here, and I'm gonna put it on the pipe, and I just shoot in the center of the pipe there, and that's how I'm gonna get my invert level and the position. So that's great. I'm just gonna go to survey jobs. You can check all these videos about the survey setting out, the setups, stations, resections, all the stuff in my setting out series. So if you want to have a look, you just jump into that videos, and yeah, let's do the survey and let's go. So I'm back in the office with my survey. I'm gonna just put my USB stick here, and I'm gonna copy the job, DXF job, and we're gonna put it on the CAD drawing. Okay, the job should be in data folder here. So open this, I called it pipe. Let's have a look. Yeah, pipe, it's this one here. I got it open now. I just double click to find. Yeah, so I got these 2 points here. You see the point I just surveyed, P1, and it's a level here 45 950, and I'm gonna just move it
to my drawing. So what I'm going to do now, I control shift copy with the base point. That's what I showed on my last video. Base point, I'm going to use 0, 0 for it, and I'm going to press enter, and I'm going to open the drainage drawing, and I'm going to overlay it in just a second. So that's my drainage drawing here. So our point should be somewhere here, and I'm going to do a control V this time. I'm going to paste it with a base point, which is 0, 0, and that should turn up in here. And now I'm going to just measure here quickly. I do aligned, and from this point, so the point is actually in the center, so that the set, whoever was doing the setting out was perfect there. And then I'm just measure from here up to here, let's say roughly. So I'm now, we're going to need the 4 meters of a pipe. So that's what I'm going to use for my order.